Right, let's just calm down until you get used to it.
That's alright, it's allowed.
I think I broke it. I'll get it. I'm standing there.
You know, just push this bit down.
Oh, here's to you, Jay.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Goodbye, single wife.
Oh no.
Hello, married man. Oh, fine, that's good.
Cough syrup, that's what it tastes like. That's nice.
Love you more. Turning again. For whatever you This may or may not come as a surprise to y'all, but I have no official qualifications for this role. Though I have done it before, and Lisa witnessed it. So either I did a really good job, or she's just a really nice sister, or more likely, she wanted to save some money. You lot, I'm sure, will let me know after which one it is. So today we're going to have some fun, and definitely do some things a bit differently, as you can already tell. So let's start by getting some audience participation. And you normally don't get to see everyone, so I want you to turn and face your beautiful guests. Now, can all the guests please blow a kiss to the lovely couple? Now, as one, I want you to shout loudly and with love to Jason and Lisa, we love you. So on three, one, two, three.
We love you.
Wow, that's pretty good, guys. Good love. Thank you. Right, turn back. Now, I was delighted when Jason and Lisa asked me to conduct the wedding ceremony for them. And I could spend lots of time telling you how amazing they both are, how much I love them both, and how much they mean to me. Or I could tell you that they gave me this role to try and stop me making the whole month of November about my 40th birthday. I told you I'd get it in. It means a lot to Jason and Lisa that all of you can be here today. Each of you are a very important part of this day, as you witness the commitment they are making to each other in the presence of those whom they love and whose friendship they cherish. I'd like to thank Lisa's bride squad, Stephanie, Laura, Caitlin and Jason. I appreciate you getting her down the stairs on time, that seemed like an effort. And thanks also to the two best men, Lewis and Craig, for keeping Jason relatively sober, I think. And ushers Alex and Lane for their help making sure everything has gone to plan today so far. And everyone's favourites, our page boy Brody and our flower girls Sophia and Harley. You all done amazing. Now Jason, Lisa, I know today we'll be littered with movie, film and I'm sure some friends quotes. So I thought I'd have a go at telling your story a little bit differently and a bit more Hollywood style. So let's start with a flashback to the late 1980s. Lisa and Jason actually grew up in the same street, would you believe? Graham Avenue in Larbert, not far from where we are now actually. However, there is a few, several years between them. So they didn't exactly get to know each other at this point. That came many years later. So let's flash forward to 2016. It was mutual friends that Jason and Lisa met. They were often at the same events, and Lisa was the one that found out Jason was single. Now, we can all picture the scene, Lisa ready with a clipboard of ideas on how she's going to get his attention. Jason, oblivious to any attention, and actually thought she was really enjoying his jokes, would you believe? Thankfully, Lisa's more direct and just asked him out. Now, the next part, I need some more romance montage music, please. I'm not covering that part. Romance. That's a bit better. Right, so the next 6 months of the relationship, dates, dancing, drinking, laughs with friends, laughs in the rain, etc, etc. And this all culminated in Jason finally moving in. Now, I'd like to add a little anecdote here. Lisa made a really big deal at Christmas, he's standing up in front of the family to make a big announcement, telling us that Jason had finally moved in. We all just looked at her bewildered, thinking he'd moved in months earlier. So. The real big moment came on Christmas Eve, when both Alex and Zach asked Jason to be their dad. I know that even now, this is the proudest moment of Jason's life. And on the 12th of May 2019, the boys officially became Cunninghams. So this means the boys beat Lisa by a clear 3 years to become a Cunningham.
That's true.
The smart money's on them both to pass the driving test before Lisa. So let's go back to the romance. No. Okay, come up with that. So together they bought their family home and moved in on the 31st of October 2019. The next big moment came on the 4th of July 2020, when Jason had his one chance, one moment, one opportunity to make his proposal. It was a date night during lockdown, which was a normal event in the calendar. So Lisa had no reason to be suspicious. Jason, though, was nervous. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, hands are heavy. Jason had a plan to wait for Lisa to leave the room so he could surprise her on her return. He stupidly forgot Lisa is capable of drinking at least two bottles of wine without going to the toilet. 3 hours passed. Jason's now sweating and agitated like the time he drank 3 cans of Monster and vodka, which wasn't a good idea. The time finally came, Lisa returned to the room, and Jason, on one knee, popped the question. And this has led us to the moment where we are now, and the rest of their story is theirs to write. Thank you. I would now like to invite Elaine forward to share a poem she selected to share with you all.
A poem to the Cunninghams. There are very few people in this world who are truly meant to be, but you two were fated in the stars, it's plain for all to see. From horror films and taxi cabs, missed signals everywhere. Friends from the start with lots of heart who promised for you, I'll be there. Adoption day, a family confirmed, no happier family that day. As Alex and Zach agreed with Mum, Jason, Daddy, was a keeper in every way. You've built a home, a family, a life, together as you should be, with an engagement planned, the perfect moment picked, full of Haribo hearts, rings and glee. Congratulations to the Cunninghams. Guess we know what kind of name it is anyway. One tied with love and laughter, joy and care, that we celebrate with you on your wedding day.
So Steph, Harlan and I have been fortunate to get to spend lots of time with Jason, Lisa, Alex and Zach. Holidays, even living together for 6 months while the house was built. And counter to what everyone thought before they moved in, we still talk about how much fun it was and the laughs we had living together. Since then, lockdowns have came and went for all of us, reminding us how important it is to enjoy the time we have together. Time is a precious thing. The time we all get to spend together is so important and it can go by so quickly. These recent years have hopefully taught us all that. Today is a very special day that Jason and Lisa have created for us all to share with them. These are the days in our lives where time moved that little bit slower. More moments are captured in pictures and videos, laughs are heard more often, and special memories are made. Thanks to both of you for allowing us all to be part of your day. And I'd now like to invite Zach up to do a reading he has selected to share with you all.
Here's your mic.
Put your back.
Dad. I know your love of movies has probably given me a lot of ideas, guidance and knowledge over the years, but I don't think your love of Predator and knowing the Braveheart speech off by heart is going to help you in your marriage. So I have put together some advice from other movies that will help you both. When Mum says I love you, do not reply with I know. The reason they are not together in the most recent Star Wars movies. If both of you ever end up overboard, make room on the raft for each other and don't keep it all to yourself. You can wake Mum up every morning with true loves and kiss, but she will probably be happier with breakfast in bed. And just finally, Mum and Dad, be your own fairy tale, as this is just another part of your happily ever after.
Yeah, right, in a moment.
I'm alright, I'm okay. Good.
To represent their love, Jason and Lisa are going to have a traditional Scottish hand fasting. I'll be tying ribbons around their joined hands as a way of confirming their union. So can you just get stand up a little bit closer? And then right hands will come to each other. Not both. Yeah. Hand fasting is an ancient Celtic marriage ritual, and if you ever wondered where the expression tying the knot came from, now you know. It's a symbolic way of showing that they are joined to one another, and although originally the idea was that they would be betrothed for a year and a day, Jason Lisa's hand fast will be for life. A hand fast is no knot of steel. Jason and Lisa are not handcuffed to each other by force, but it's a strong knot because it is the will of Jason and Lisa to make it so. May it never come undone under the strain of the storms of life. May it sit lightly and pleasantly upon you that you may walk through life hand in hand, mind with mind, and heart to heart. Now I now ask you both to repeat after me. I promise to be faithful.
I promise to be faithful.
And to never believe the grass is greener somewhere else.
And to never believe the grass is greener somewhere else.
I promise to be courageously honest.
I promise to be courageously honest.
Tough one, eh? Even when the truth is hard.
Even when the truth is hard.
I promise to be slow to anger and quick to forgive.
I promise to be slow to anger and quick to forgive.
I promise to surprise you.
I promise to surprise you.
I promise to always stand beside you.
I promise to always stand beside you.
I promise to trust you, respect you, honour you and support you.
I promise to trust you, respect you, honour you, and support you.
That was a test. I promise to be your light in the dark.
I promise to be your light in the dark.
I promise to love you always.
I promise to love you always.
Put your hands apart and step back. These cords came as two and leave as one. As they are tied, so you are tied. Hold this safe as a symbol of your individual love for the other in respect of you joining. Right, now a bit more audience participation required. Where are they? Come on out. Right, need the groomsmen's support. The groomswoman's support.
Oh yeah.
So you know what's coming. Now they've tied the knot, we want you all to take a shot.
Hey guys. Yes, I've got it. Jason. Have a look.
Do you guys have a shot? I mean,
I like when you have tight shoulders.
Are you Celtic? No. These are the people
So. So I've not filled up too much. Right, have we caused enough chaos?
Yeah.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, welcome. Skies, welcome to take a shot, and the couple will join you up front drinking from the plate. Really nice, eh?
Who made them?
Jesus!
Who made them? If anyone would like the recipe, speak to Jason.
Yeah.
Everyone good? Yes. Jason, it went down well. So, everyone's attention please. Jason and Lisa have prepared some personal vows they will now share with each other in the presence of everyone here. Jason.
You know how much I like to stretch out a story, so I promise I'll try and keep this as brief as I can. Even though I could spend all day talking about how much I love you and how amazing you are. I was thinking about how can I let you know exactly how much I feel about you, and then I thought I would explain it in the only way I know how. You are more adorable than Bluey. You're more awe-inspiring than Avatar. You're more dreamy than Inception. You're smarter than the Big Bang Theory. You're funnier than Friends. You're a better singer than Hamilton. You're more family-orientated than the Modern Family. You're more caring than Grey's Anatomy. Stronger than the Incredible Hulk. More stylish than the Devil Wears Prada. And you love true crime more than CSI. More incredible than The Incredibles. Basically, you're my favourite blockbuster. I am incredibly lucky to become your husband. You have made me the happiest that I could ever imagine. You brought these amazing boys into my life and helped me become the father that I am today. I am eternally grateful to you for that. Take my hand, please. Together, there's nothing that we can't do. I promise to allow you to organise all of our adventures. I will keep you laughing with my terrible jokes. I will keep your heart full of love and your glass full of wine. And I promise to love you unconditionally for as long as I live.
Sneaky. Lisa.
Okay. Jason, just over 6.5 years ago, I thought our little family of three was all that we needed, until you came into our lives and I realised that you were the final piece I hadn't known was missing to complete our team. Our lives ran parallel to each other, albeit you were 5 years behind. Growing up in the same street, going to the same schools, working at the same place and eventually knowing each other through mutual friends, it seems like we were always meant to be. I just need you to catch up to a suitable age. From the moment we started dating, I knew you were the one, my soulmate, best friend and partner in crime for life. You're the most amazing dad, and although I chose you as my partner, the boys very, very firmly chose you when they asked you on that Christmas Eve to be their dad. Jason, these are my promises to you. I will always have a spreadsheet and clipboard ready for every event in your life, and maybe allow you to ring it once in a while.
Lies.
I will always be your number one cheerleader and support you in everything you want to achieve. I will be by your side in sickness, health, happiness, sadness, good times, hard times, and all the exciting chapters we have ahead of us. I love you with all my heart and can't wait for all the memories we'll be making now and in the future.
Now we move into the formal part of the ceremony. Jason, Lisa, it's time to make your commitments to each other. Lewis,
yes.
Things please. On top it. Jason, if you'd now like to make your vows to Lisa, will you please repeat these words after me? I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Jason Stewart Cunningham.
To witness that I, Jason Stewart Cunningham.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
That I accept you, Lisa Helen White.
That I
That I accept you, Lisa Helen White.
That I accept you, Lisa Helen White.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
And Lisa, if you would now like to make your vows to Jason, please repeat these words after me.
Yep.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
That I, Lisa Helen White.
That I, Lisa Helen White.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
That I accept you, Jason Shute.
What?
I accept you, Jason Stewart Cunningham.
I accept you, Jason Stewart Cunningham.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
Jason and Lisa, do you take one another as partners from this day forward as husband and wife? Please yell hearty, we do.
We do.
And to everyone here, do you promise to stand by this couple, to remind them of their vows and to act as an example of love and family? Please yell a hearty, we do.
We do!
Jason and Lisa, you've chosen to marry and have pledged your love, respect and commitment for each other. You've promised to stand by each other through whatever your lives together may bring. Following the declarations made before me and in the presence of these witnesses, it is now my pleasant duty, Jason and Lisa, to pronounce you husband and wife. As you seal this moment, I ask you and everyone here present, family and friends, the immediate circle of love within which you dwell, to treasure the memory of the happiness of this special day and to join with me in wishing you the greatest happiness and success in your future lives together from this moment on. Jason, you may now kiss the bride. I am sure you've all felt warm by this occasion and recognise that this ceremony has been a meaningful one for everyone here. May you always reflect upon these proceedings and recall the happiness of this day. In a moment, celebratory drinks will be served and you can toast the bride and groom before the wedding party, have some photographs taken. You'll also see a white postbox at the entrance for any cards you may wish to leave for the newlyweds. And can I encourage you all throughout the day to leave a voice message on the old-fashioned red telephone out there, although I think the more drunk the better, so as the day gets on. To conclude, I'd like to thank you all very much for being here on this very special occasion. And finally, I'd like to give my own personal good wishes to Jason and Lisa and me. Give some advice in the form of a little poem. To keep your marriage brimming with love in the loving cup, whenever you're wrong, admit it, and whenever you're right, shut up. If you'd please be upstanding, it gives me the greatest pleasure to present to you Jason and Lisa, now Mr. and Mrs. Cunningham.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least, for most of the questions in my heart. Like, why are we here and where do we go? And knock on me so hard. And it's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. I find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between, with only two, just me and you. Not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. soul, so pretty when I sleep. Hey, now and when I wake up, you look so pretty sleeping next to me. But there is not enough time, and there is no song I could sing, and there is no combination of words I could say. But I will still tell you one thing, we're better together.
Just remember, darling, all the while you belong to me. See the marketplace in old Algiers. Send me photographs and souvenirs. Just remember, when a dream appears, you belong to me. I'll be so alone without you. Maybe you'll be lonesome too and blue.
ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you all to please be upstanding? Raise the roof and welcome the very new Mr. and Mrs. Cunningham!
Piper's toast, not any old toast, but the oldest toast in Scotland. It goes back over 300 years to the last of the clan system and to the first of the Highland regiments. And it's said in mother tongue, Gaelic. Slánte sonas, agus beata scigéirs. That's quite simple to put. It's health, wealth and happiness. To you both. Slánte ba! We're now going to cut the cake. So please, 3, 2, 1. Oh,
yeah. I'm so sorry.
Those of you who don't like a photo before the cake topples. Please step forward, those of you who would like to take a photo.
Stephen's 40th birthday. Bear with me till I get the correct one.
I think you're older than that.
Here we go. Hi everyone, thank you for all coming to celebrate such a special day. Think we can all agree it's been a wonderful day so far, celebrating the wedding of Jason and Lisa. I am so proud to walk Lisa down the aisle. She's looking beautiful and I love the fact Stephen married again, a real family affair. For those of you who don't know me, I am Alan, Lisa's dad. I am responsible for all Lisa's good habits. I think I need to explain. I can be an emotional guy at times. The family have bets on how long before I cry. I will try to make it through the speech and stay away from the soppy stuff. But whoever said right at the start when we went up the stair, I was in bits. Now I'm going to try and get through this. Jason, we would like to welcome to the family officially. Thank you for looking after our Lisa and the boys, always being there for her, being the right hand man, always making her laugh. Oops, wait, I'm sorry. I can't read you right, Jason. Seriously, after meeting Jason, both Jill and I thought he was such a likeable lad. On behalf of the Hype Clan, Jason, I would like to apologise now for Lisa's inability to say sorry. It's a family trait, and all my kids have it. You also had to learn that Lisa is always right, even if she is wrong. Again, my fault. Jason, I remember the first Christmas you joined us. Later in the night, after too many malts, you asked me for Lisa's hand in marriage. I am so pleased, and I can still remember thinking, thank God someone wants her. The truth hurts. I'm so happy for them. You can see when they are together how much they love each other. And Jason took on the role of dad and loved my two grandsons as if they were his own. As a family, I think we all can agree, it was amazing that the boys asked Jason to adopt him, creating their wonderful family of four.
How many pages you got there?
That was back in 2019. Lisa, that was your chance to run, but here we are. Now on to Lisa. Oh, I know she will be worried about what I have to say. I was told not to embarrass her, but I have never liked being told what to do. Another big trait, isn't that right, Jill? So many tales of binge drinking, dogs, collect you from one-night stands, police knocking on the door during the night, not to mention the second difficult asthma. Well, she does not need to worry. I am not going to talk about any of that, even though I am now short of material. Don't look so worried, people. I was only joking. There's only one asthma. She was a wonderful baby, so content, came home from the hospital and slept all night. She loved dressing up. I was always remember the bright red patent shoes she wore on her first day of school. She thought she was Dorothy, Wizard of Oz. And when Stevie was young, he couldn't pronounce Lisa's name. He called her Pop. From then on, he called her Lisa Pop. But she will answer to anything these days. Wine, yes please. I remember taking them both to the old grounds in Addison Age on their bikes, which is now Lambert Hospital, Falkirk Hospital. Stephen shot off down a steep hill and I chased after him. Lisa followed behind. I shouted to Stephen to brake, brake, which Lisa did and went straight over the handle. She blames me still for the indentation in her chin. People pay for cosmetic surgery later in their life. Being a responsible parent, I save her a lot of money. Lisa's skills on wheels has continued. Not sure if I will ever recover from the driving lessons in the same area. I should have learned. Picture the scene on a hot summer's day, windows were down. We went down the same hill at the hospital, turned a corner, and we ended up with all the bushes coming through the windows of the car. At least now she has her chauffeur, Jason, driving her here. Only be a few years now till Alex is driving her. Hope you haven't inherited your mum's skills, or should I say lack of. Everyone who knows Lisa is such a special person. Fiercely loyal, totally dependable, and fun-loving. She is very family-oriented. and one of the best party planners we know. She loves a full house. Family means everything to her, and the way she raised our grandkids, Alex and Zach, on her own, never asked for any help, just shows such a strong character she is. Then along came Jason and supported her just at the right time. Now it's time for me to part wisdom and give you the secrets and advice to a long and happy marriage. Jason, have a good sense of humour and a short memory. Lisa, go ask Jim. Okay, I've been up here long enough. Now time for some decent speeches. So please be upstanding for the toast and raise a glass. Lisa and Jason, neither of you are perfect, but you are perfect together. We are so proud of you and wishing you both every happiness for the future to the new Mr. and Mrs. Cunningham.
Cheers. Cheers. Hey.
On behalf of my beautiful wife, I just want to thank you all for being here and making our day so special. We have so many people to thank for today, and I can't get through every single one of you. If I've missed anyone out, then apologies, I'm so sorry. Our friends and family mean so much to us and have helped us. So a massive thank you to Vic for the cake. Sorry, I nearly destroyed it, but my best men will get you a drink later on. Lindsay and David, thank you for the flowers. My best men will get you a drink later on. Thanks to Elaine for the invites, the favours, Holly for the table plan. Well done. Best friends, thanks. Elaine, Jen and Vic for trawling through a beach for hundreds of white pebbles. Best friends, thanks. Thanks to the beautiful bride squad. Thank you. You look amazing.
Thanks.
And also thank you for adhering to Lisa's spreadsheets and our SAS timelines. You guys look amazing, and don't worry, you nearly made it. Nearly there. Thanks to Zach and Elaine for the lovely words at the seminary, and Alex for his sick DJ skills. Stephen, thank you for the best fake ceremony you've ever done. You should do this for a living. I'm not sure if you've heard that at all today. Wait a minute, is it your birthday? Happy 40th. Happy 40th. My best friend will get you a drink later on. To the groomsmen, cheers for keeping me as calm as I can be. I'll wait until after your speeches to see if I want to thank you for anything else. In all seriousness though, we are so thankful for everyone coming near and far to be with us at our wedding today. I want to thank Alan and Jill for welcoming me into your family. Hold it together. Welcoming me into your family as if I was one of your own. When I asked for Lisa's hand, you had no doubt that I could look after her. Alan, your words were actually, I'm sure she'll like that. Still asking for permission, by the way. I unfortunately never got to meet Lisa's mum, Magsie, but I wish I could. Even if it was just to let her know that she's raised the most beautiful human being that I've ever met. I'm sure you'd all agree. According to my time and Lisa's spreadsheet, that's my allocation done. So
finally, I want you all to have the best time and raise a glass to us all. And then I'll pass you on to my best man. Cheers. Cheers.
Now, I've started in a bad way because I say good afternoon, but it's a bit dark outside, so I have to be good evening, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Craig, and according to Jason, I'm one of the two men in the room he considers to be better than him. Now, it's all right, I've got a laugh, I can relax now. Now, I don't mind admitting I've been feeling a bit nervous about giving this speech, and one of the main things I wanted to avoid was just plagiarising stuff I could find on the internet. Anyway, before we move on to how I met, insert name here, I'd like to take this opportunity on behalf of the wedding party to thank him for his kind words, and both Lisa and Jason for including everyone here in this special day. I also want to congratulate the bridal party on doing a great job of keeping Lisa sane, calm, and absolutely gorgeous on a day when her desire to go full Monica is probably struggling to break free, but so far not a clipboard or a headset in sight, so that's good. I'm going to add one last special thank you to the youngest and my favourite frenemy, Zach, for ensuring that no blood has so far been shed, despite his enthusiastic request to the man in the kilt shop to have a sword included with his. Now, I'd like to be able to stand here and tell you that I remember the day that I met Jason, as I've heard others describe it over the years as an experience, or as my daughter Abigail once compared it to, a bit like meeting Goofy at Disney World. But after nearly 23 years, it simply feels like he's always been there. The victor to my Jack, who always makes me laugh, often unintentionally, and one of the genuinely nicest guys that I know. Now, back then, I'd have been a young boy desperately looking for a new friend on the first day at a new school. He would have been a lanky young boy who hadn't quite grown into his ears yet. A sort of weird ginger kid to hang about with. Now, who would have known that all these years later, I would have the honour of standing up here and being one of his best men, giving him a speech on the day he married the love of his life. And no, I'm not talking about the one he never fails to turn on, his PlayStation 5. Back then, we were just a couple of stupid teenage boys who did what best friends did. Movie nights, confiding in each other about the girls we fancied but would never get up the courage to ask out, and playing GoldenEye on the N64. As time went on, we would grow up. I don't know about that. Get jobs, discover Jack Daniels, that was a new plan. Game nights became some of the truly worst karaoke nights you've ever heard. And occasionally we would get up the courage to ask out a girl that we actually fancied. Jason, however, was always a bit more brave when it came to that side. Even though most of his relationships ended up being off the rails eventually. He knows what's coming. Except one, which went so on the rails, it resulted in 12 train cancellations, a hefty mechanics bill, a trip to the hospital, and an article in the Falkirk Herald. Which I have a picture of on my phone, so I'll show you. Then, one weekend in July 2016, my sister Vicky threw a party. And Jason, always good for a laugh, was a fan favourite on the guest list, or so I'm told. Fast forward several hours, drinks and rounds of drunk twister later, and into the party walks an absolute knockout, completely overdressed and glammed up for the occasion, who had been at a wedding. Now, I know what you're thinking, it wasn't me. It was a friend, and if you believe the stories, his ex-childhood babysitter. Now, a wee spark was immediately noticed between the two of them. And suddenly, despite secretly scheming that night to hook him up with somebody else, they decided that, no, we'll just get the two of them together instead. Although, I'm not sure there was that much effort required. Displaying more endurance than the rest, Jason and Lisa were eventually the last one standing, which is quite often the case at a party. And the pair decided to settle on the couch to watch a movie. Jason, being Larbert's answer to Casanova, picked that famously romantic film, guaranteed to melt a girl's heart, Deadpool. He then proceeded to spend most of the next hour and a half completely engrossed in the violent antics of Ryan Reynolds and completely oblivious to the subtle hints that Lisa was giving him, until finally she took a direct approach that couldn't be ignored, or as Deadpool would say, she went, maximum effort. Vicky awoke the next morning to find no sign of either of them, and it seems that Jason, deeply concerned for Lisa's safety and feeling rather heroic himself, had decided to escort her home in the wee hours of the morning. And from that day forward, it was obvious from the outset to those of us watching closely that something special was happening. From the outside, it looked easy, like two pieces of a puzzle that fit together perfectly. Lisa liked to organise, Jason liked to be told what to do. Lisa liked to make cheesecake, Jason liked to eat cheesecake. Lisa liked to drink wine, and Jason was pretty good at keeping the glass topped up. He became the Chandler to her Monica, and the rest of us embraced Lisa as one of our dearest friends. Of course, one of the best parts of the relationship was watching Jason grow into the role as a parent to the boys, Zach and Alex. From the beginning, they were great pals, but gradually this became something more, with Jason and Lisa settling into what we could all tell by this point was going to be the rest of their lives together. No longer just a couple, but a family. Then one Christmas Eve, when the boys asked Jason to adopt them, he became dad, and the boys officially became Cunninghams. Suddenly, Lisa found herself outnumbered by Cunningham boys, and despite dropping many hints, including threatening to run away with me if they didn't hurry up at one point, she had no choice but to just wait patiently for her turn. There were positive signs that it was coming, of course, like the quite literal one that Jason put up on the outside of her new home that said, "The Cunninghams." But she hung in there and knew eventually that the question would come. And obviously, for those of us here today, it did. When on the 4th of July 2020, Lisa opened the door to the living room to find Jason on his knees with an engagement ring in his hands and a nervous look on his face. I'm not sure if he realised the irony of asking her to spend the rest of their lives together on Independence Day, but that's our Jason. The rest is history. The rest is history. So at this point, before Jason blows out the candle, which for anyone who's ever been to one of their house parties knows is the usual signal it's time for us all to go home, I'd like to ask everyone to stand and raise a glass and join in me in wishing the happy couple and two of our dearest friends a lifetime full of happy and loving memories. To the Cunninghams! Right, Lewis, it's your turn.
Thanks, Steve. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to the fake wedding, or I would call it a circus.
Don't call
that
wedding a circus.
Jason and Lisa Cunningham. Finally, Lisa, the door plan made sense. First, I think the nice stuff out of the way. I think we can all agree that Stephen has done a fantastic and...
Did I Stephen? It's a miracle!
You've got
pretty quick.
I know,
huh? Off mode.
But I agree, Stephen's done a fantastic and neat job at the ceremony. But it's not every day you can say that you manage your sister. Bridesmaids and bridesmen, you're all looking stunning today. Especially that one over there. No, you're
just saying. I thought it was
For people who don't know who I am, and I can't put two and two together, like me and Jason, I'm obviously a younger and better looking brother. Just saying that, we didn't mistake Craig as Jason's brother. Just so you know, it's the hair that gives that away, obviously. Slightly more serious note, it's nice to finally welcome Lisa as a Cunningham, even though I've always felt like she's a sister, an older sister. Much older sister. I went on for ages there, but I just thought, boys, you've done your mum and dad so proud today, and we love you both dearly. The day that you officially adopted our family, that was one of the happiest and most important days of Jason's life, I can say it sincerely. To see Jason, that's made me proud as brother and uncle, and I'd just like to show the appreciation. I know that Harris and Zach would decide to do an interpretive dance for you all today. So you know what that was? Well, but I'm not on that pastor, though. Between Alex knocking out of his own house and Zach throwing red wine over the living room walls at home, quite literally, it wouldn't be the same without this. Now on to the person that wears the trousers in the new Clareham household, Lisa. You're looking absolutely beautiful today, and we can all agree that Jason is definitely punching. It's true, but the day I found out you could drink more wine than me, I thought, Jason, you'd better put a ring on that. Well, that's an obvious ass. Now, Jason.
2 seconds,
you're going to crack the fires. Of all the nice things I could have said about everyone, I've been scratching my head, and all I can say is you scrub it well, and that's a lovely tartan that you've got on. Seriously though, I've always looked up to you and copied you from the day I was born. Except when you do silly things, which is a lot by the way. Granted, mainly when you're younger, for example, the time I had to go in A&E with a pencil rubber stuck in the ear. Or when the land before your McDonald's birthday party earlier, and buying the head in the shelf from Tesco's resulting having to get your head glued back together. Or when you thought marrying Lisa was a great idea and playing Sierra. I say that out, so sorry. There's time for Jason would use his brain and result in some pretty funny outcomes, like attending Unity to study forensic investigating and dropping out and delivering pizzas for Domino's. Where's Sandy? Sandy, I'm always going to do something. Pizza, Anna. That's a private stag new joke. Speaking of stag new, there's not much I can discuss, mainly because my children are here. I can see that the knockoff version of Deadpool can't handle his firearms quite as good as the real one. If anyone hasn't seen the video yet, you should. It's good viewing. Now, if anyone wants some entertainment later, just give Jason a few shots of vodka and find a couple of Englishmen. I'm sure there's a couple in here. And you'll hear the most botched Braveheart speech in the world.
Awful.
That was terrible, wasn't it?
Awful.
Jason, it's very easy to talk to, and as the patience I've seen, which is all the qualities you want to be a driver instructor. But as Craig rushed on earlier, he tried it once and the car landed on a railway track, so he's best thing to like baiting cakes, but that's be a bit of a... Yeah, as you can imagine, growing up was often a mistake for Jason and vice versa. Jason took full advantage of this, however, when people would buy him drinks thinking it was me when they were right out, which is more obliged to take, so I never really got any in return. So today, if anyone wants to buy Jason a drink, I'll happily oblige. On that note, I'd like to ask everyone if you'd please stop standing and raise your glass to the bride and groom, my brother and sister, the Curryhams.
Caitlin and I would like to sing a song. Don't worry, I'm only good.
I think she's like, I'm up for it.
So, we just want to get everyone's attention to speak for a minute. Lisa's asked that both of us introduce a task that we would like to get everyone and the guests to, all of the guests to participate in. But given that Lisa granted us this time to speak, we thought we would take full advantage.
Shut up.
Lisa, our big sis, today has been such a beautiful day. We're speaking on behalf of all your bridal party, that we feel so proud to be part of your special day. We always knew that you would look exceptional, but nothing could prepare us for just how good you truly look.
Jason, our new brother-in-law. You truly are one of the good guys in life, and by far our favourite family member.
Thank you.
We want to thank you for not only being the best partner to our sister, Lisa, but also for being the greatest dad to both of our nephews. grave at taking Lisa on in life. So we just want to remind you of just a couple of things. Always stick to the plan. Don't ever question the plan. Don't ever change the plan. And for the love of God, just remember that there is always a plan.
And always respect your elders. In all seriousness, you have made Lisa the happiest woman in the world. So far, no, so for that, thank you.
So far.
We both wish you all the health, love and happiness in your marriage, and please just always continue to be yourselves.
Hold on,
Caitlin,
there's not a reason why
we were
given this mic.
Oh yeah. Sorry, I forgot about that one. So in a moment, once the music starts.
Why the hell are you begging me?
Once the music starts, the bride and groom have been tasked to join each of you at your tables for a group photo. So can we kindly ask you all, I know you might not want to, but all support them and get a photo with them. And they're basically, Lisa, for your benefit, there are rules. Don't worry. You have the length of the song to capture your snaps. So you better get your running shoes on.
Okay, so we wish you all good luck and we can't wait to celebrate and continue partying the night on as the girls.
Mr. and Mrs. Cunningham!
Best things fly by so fast.